Good morning and a very warm welcome to everyone to our service of Holy Communion on this sixth Sunday of Easter, a Sunday which is often known as Rogation Sunday, a Sunday when we give thanks to God for his abundant provision to us, for our land, for our crops, for our food, and all those who work on the land. As you will see, this service is not taking place in my study where it has been for the last few weeks of lockdown. And that is because we are now given permission as clergy to come into our churches and to lead services of Holy Communion and prayer. And so this morning's service is led here in the beautiful Church of Holy Trinity in Eckington. And I'm going to be saying a little bit more about that later in the service. As is required for services of Holy Communion to take place, there must be at least one other person present. And so my daughter Megan is also with me, and she is going to be operating the iPad to enable the recording of this service, and she is also going to be reading the epistle. And so let us now quieten our hearts as we come before God in worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
We say together the words of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ our Passover Lamb has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil, and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. We say together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say together the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And the collect for this Sunday. God God, our Redeemer, who has delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of thy Son, grant that as by his death he hath recalled us to life, so that by his continual presence in us he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. Megan is now going to give us our epistle reading.
The reading today is taken from Acts chapter 17, verses 22 to 31. Then Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, "Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, 'To an unknown God.' What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you: the God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands, as though he needed everything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor he made all nations to inhabit the world, the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they would search for God, and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being. As even some of your own poets have said, 'For we too are his offspring.' Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in the Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father. And I will love them and reveal myself to them. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I mentioned at the start of the service that this service is taking place from a church following permission by the House of Bishops to allow clergy to start leading services from our churches, as a beginning to the reopening of our church buildings once once again for public worship. This is, of course, a great relief and a source of comfort to many of us as we begin to see the start of returning to a normal practice of worship. However, this is only the beginning, and since this decision has been made, the reality of what will be practically needed to make this happen has become more apparent. For in a rural area, with some 15 churches around the Green Hill, and with a large proportion of the church community still shielding and isolating, this means that it may be some significant time before we can all enjoy coming back to our churches for regular worship, and allowing weddings and other services to take place within them. So, although today is a start and somewhat of a new beginning, we need to recognise that given the magnitude of the coronavirus pandemic, we will not and cannot return to exactly how things were in the past. Our gospel reading speaks of a new beginning for the disciples, as Jesus points to a time when he will no longer be with them physically, when he ascends to his Father in heaven. And this Thursday, we will be celebrating the Festival of Ascension. And to mark this festival, I will be leading at 11 o'clock in the morning a service of Holy Communion from here, which will be recorded and uploaded onto YouTube for anyone who wishes to join me by viewing it later in the day. Jesus promised the disciples that when he left them, they would not be on their own, but would be accompanied throughout their lives by the Holy Spirit, a Spirit of truth, the advocate, the comforter, and the ever-present bringer of counsel, support, and peace. And through these dark times, when we are largely still at home and cannot yet come back to our churches, this Spirit of truth is uniting us all. Why? Because it lives within us, and it is the living presence which connects us together as a community of believers, and similarly connects us to God the Father and to God the Son. As such, we will never be alone, because we are united in this love, a love which not even death could break or separate us from. Jesus, though we cannot see him, has not left us orphaned, but promises that he will always be with us, wherever we are, and in whatever circumstances we find ourselves in. Therefore, although it may feel strange that there is only Megan and myself in this building here this morning, I am aware that we are all connected, wherever we may be, through our worship to the God who loves us, and who has revealed himself to us through Jesus Christ our Lord. And so, as we meet around the Lord's table, even though we cannot all be physically present together, let us celebrate that oneness with Christ through the celebration of the Eucharist, through the elements knowing that we do not worship an unknown God, but one who knows each one of us personally and intimately, and who promises us a life in all its richness and fulfillment. Then let us give thanks for all that God gives us as we face the week ahead, giving him praise for his enduring love and faithfulness. Amen. Let us now declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit in the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. Blessed are you, Lord our God, for out of your love you have made all things. You have come to us and give yourself to us. Help us to be aware of your love in our lives and to give ourselves to you in love and in doing your will. Blessed are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty and merciful God, from you comes every good and perfect gift. On this Rogation Sunday, we ask you to bless our land, such that it may bring forth abundant fruits and crops in due season. We pray for all those who labour in farms and market gardens, and we give thanks for all that they do to bring food to our shops and to our tables, recognizing that you are a God who provides for us so generously. May we forever lift our hearts in grateful praise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, as we acknowledge our beautiful planet, we do not currently see borders and battle lines, religions and rivalries, different coloured countries and age-old hatreds. Instead, we see a world of common causes and a single people battling against an invisible enemy of the coronavirus. Build up our confidence in a vision of healing, peace, equality and human flourishing, so that war becomes a relic of the past and reconciliation and one healed world becomes the goal of every nation. We pray for all world leaders seeking a way through this terrible pandemic, for the decisions which they take, which has an impact on the lives of so many. And we pray that a vaccine may soon be found. We thank you for all the people working on the front line of fighting this virus. And we ask for your protection on them and on all that they do. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of the Church, we thank you for our churches and especially for those in the Diocese of Worcester. We thank you for people who have flowed in and out of their doors over so many years, faithful or searching, joyful or sad, hopeful or anxious. At this time, when our church buildings are largely closed, may people still find a way to your loving presence through the actions of your people on earth. Bless, O Lord, Bishop John of Worcester, Bishop Martin of Dudley, Archdeacons Robert and Nikki, all clergy and authorised lay ministers across this diocese, and all seeking to be your witnesses and sharing your good news. We pray especially for the church communities in the Breedon Hill Group, and ask that you continue to strengthen and support all within these communities when we can no longer be physically present together. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, who through your Son Jesus Christ called his followers to love God and love your neighbour, in this week of Christian Aid, bless all who work for that organisation. Such that sponsoring churches and many others may be encouraged to respond to Christ's command to care for all in need through the giving of financial donations. And may all monies raised then be used wisely, so that we may have the confidence and hope that poverty can be ended, despite all that might stand in the way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we bring you all those known to us who are suffering in mind, body, or soul. And we remember especially those who are ill with the coronavirus, and those who are in our local hospitals, hospices, and care homes. We remember those known to us and ask that your peace and love will surround them, bringing them healing, comfort, and strength. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we thank you for those who have travelled before us on the way of the cross and are now at peace in your eternal presence. We pray especially for those who have died this week, or who are facing the end of their journey here on earth. Help us to live our lives in the assurance of your promise that this road of faith will lead to your kingdom. And when our time comes, we pray that we will rise with all those saints who have gone before. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, finally we pray for ourselves, for our families, and for all those for whom we care. In these days of lockdown, may you bless our homes, our relationships with each other, and on all those activities in which we will engage in the coming days, so that in all things your risen Son may be glorified, now and forever. Merciful Lord, accept these prayers for the sake of your risen Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you,
and also with you.
Lord be with you,
and also with you.
Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father. And in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise, and opened to them his gates of his life eternal. And so, in this joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymns of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great High Priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. God, our Father, whose Son, Jesus Christ, gives the water of eternal life, may we thirst for you, the spring of life and source of goodness, through him who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
We give thanks for the saving death and resurrection of Jesus and ask him to be with us now. Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits you have given us, for all the pains and insults you have borne for us. And since we cannot now receive you sacramentally, We ask you to come spiritually into our hearts, O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother. May we know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen. And so, a final prayer of blessing. The God of peace, who brought you again from the dead, our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work you do, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you and with all you love, now and forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks
be
to God.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
It has been lovely to share this service of Holy Communion with you this morning, and I do hope that you will join me once again at the same time next week. The hope is that we will look to increase the number of churches from which this service can be recorded, and also increasing the number of people who can be involved in it. We're also looking to start a regular service of Compline at 7 o'clock on a Thursday evening through Zoom. And if anyone is interested in joining us in this service, then please contact me at Eckington Vicarage and we will send you an invitation to join us. And so I now wish you a very blessed and healthy week ahead.